making your church child-friendly. I am 72 years old, and as a child, we moved a lot. I remember only one of the many church's pastors from my childhood. I was 5, and his name was Henry Morgan, and he was from Wales, and every Sunday after church, he shook my hand, thanked me for coming, and asked God to bless me during the coming week. The handshake and personal attention were great, the memory of a lifetime. But Pastor Morgan did more. One thing I remember still was the guided tour of the church. He personally walked with my parents, my brothers, and I on an adventure in churchland. We learned where the fire escapes and unlocked doors were, and the bathrooms. We got to see the kitchen and the office where there were phones. Afterward, I felt comfortable in the church building and truly welcomed. The next thing I remember about this church were the pictures of Jesus hung at child's height. They were all through the church, but the one I remember most is the one by my pew. I was too short to see anything but the heads of those in front of me, so I looked off to the side, and at just my height was a picture of Jesus knocking at the heart's door. I liked very much listening to Pastor Morgan's Welsh accent, but I recalled nothing he said, at least not consciously, but will always remember the picture and what it made me feel. There's actually very solid science behind Christian art. What we see is stored in the permanent memory part of our brain. If these memories were not permanent, we could not find our way around our own home. What we hear, however, is stored in temporary storage, on the average, about 2 weeks. Church or home, I remain a super fan of Christian art. Some of my other favorites are Christ Our Pilot, The Good Shepherd, and Christ Walking on the Water. Nearly two-thirds of all Christians accept Christ before age 18. Why wouldn't we do our best to make our church building child-friendly? Third on our list of making a church child-friendly is giving them something to do. According to Dr. Margaret Mead and nearly all modern anthropologists, the one thing that gives a child a sense of belonging is being a contributor, having something to do. My own number one thought is to arm each child in the church with invitations to visit their Sunday school. Child-to-child evangelism is likely the one thing most likely to reach this next generation. The printed invitation should have the name of the church, address, phone number, time class starts, and, if available, a phone number to get a free ride, or, if desired, the child could offer his parents as chauffeurs. This child-to-child outreach is critical in any age where many churches are closing their Sunday school and VBS programs. A likely explanation for the huge increase in church closings, over 10,000 a year over the past 20 years. Making a church child-friendly is literally a matter of survival, of not abandoning the next generation. Fourth on the list is helping children experience God, at least as much as explaining Him. The difference between hearing about God and hearing from God. We pray that as many church leaders, current and future, visit www.teachustopray.com and set up prayer cups for each of the children they serve or will serve. A child who has had just one answered prayer will remember it all of his or her life. After a child has his or her prayer cup and puts in the first prayer, we tell them simply that we can't tell God what to do, we ask Him what we should do or believe. That we can't move God's hand, it belongs to Him. But He has given us His heart and will surely minister to our heart. Every child in a church should know that God, Emmanuel, is truly real and truly is with us with the evidence of at least one answered prayer. There is no good place for a reminder of the need to do background checks on those who work with children. So we will put ours here. But Being child-friendly definitely means keeping children safe from would-be abusers. A good rule of thumb is always have two adults present, or at least one adult and one mature teen, when working with children. We should, however, focus on the positive more than the negative. We pray you watch part two of this video, but especially that you remember the key points of this first part. 1. Greet each child as they come or leave. Personally, we like shaking hands as they leave and inviting them back. 2. Make sure each child gets a tour of the church, especially the fire escapes and bathrooms, but also the rooms where people are. 3. Putting art and scriptures at child's height. 4. Child-to-child evangelism. 5. Having a prayer cup for each child and, as requested, pray for them. We pray that later in the day you return to our YouTube channel for part 2 of Making Your Church Child-Friendly. And print out the file copies at www.BibleParent.com.